In this video, I'm gonna show you how to play Skate 3 on PC using RPCS3. The game runs great on it. Not only you can increase the resolution, but it also supports 120 FPS or higher. I'll show you the settings to get the best quality and stability starting right now. We'll begin by downloading RPCS3, the PS3 emulator. I'll put the link down below, and here on the main page, you just have to click here on the download button, and then you download the emulator for the operational system you're using. In my case, I'm using Windows, so I'm gonna click on this one and then place it on the folder of your preference on your PC. It will come as a zipped file, so you have to extract it with either WinRAR or 7-zip. In my case, I'm using 7-zip, so I'm just gonna extract the file here. And you can go ahead and delete the original one. We're not gonna need that anymore. And to begin, you just have to double click here on rpcs3.ex to start the installation. And here there's a few options if you want to create a desktop shortcut and stuff. I would not recommend using the dark theme yet, so I'm gonna turn this off. And then just click here on do not show again, and I have read the quick start guide. And then just select here on continue. And there you go, we have RPCS3 on our computer. First, we have to install the PS3 firmware on the emulator, and we can get that on the official Sony website. This is the place right here, the link will be down below, and on this page, you want to scroll down here to the bottom a little bit, and where it says how to update PS3 system software, you want to click here on update using a computer, and then you just click on download PS3 update, and place the file on the same emulator folder. If for some reason the download doesn't start when you click on it, then you have to click on it with the right button on your mouse and then select copy link address and then paste the link on your browser and press enter. Then the download will start. Now back on the emulator folder, I already downloaded my firmware here. It is this file, the PS3 update. Now you want to go to the emulator and right here, click on file and click on install firmware. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you just have to double click here on the PS3 update and it will install the firmware on RPCS3. Click here and do not show again and then click OK. And now it will install these PPU modules, but this shouldn't take long. And while you wait for it to finish, this will be a good time to subscribe to the channel and also leave a like on this video. I would really appreciate it. Now, with the emulator installed, I want you to go back to the installation folder right here, and you're gonna notice this folder here called Games that was already created when you installed the emulator. That's because this is the folder that the emulator is going to scan for new games by default. So this is where you're going to be placing the Skate 3 game files. Leave it as a folder like this one right here, and inside you're gonna have the game files, and I can't show you here on the video where to go to get the game because this is against YouTube's policy. Once the files are in place, you're gonna go back to the emulator and you're gonna click here on file and you're gonna click here on add games. It should open the emulator folder by default, so now you're gonna double click on the games folder and then you're gonna click on the Skate 3 folder once. And you're gonna click here on the bottom, select folder. And just like that, the game will appear here on the emulator. But this is the vanilla version of the game. We don't have the updates yet. And there is an easy way to update your games on RPCS3. Using this tool right here, Rusty PSN, the link will be down below as well. So here on this page, you just wanna click here on the latest release available. It is version 3.7. And then just scroll down here to the bottom and you have to download this file right here, the rustypsn-ege-windows.zip. Download this file if you are using Windows like I am. You can place it on the same emulator folder. Now back on the RPCS3 folder, the file is right here, the rustypsn that is, so you just have to extract the single .ex file that is inside of it with either WinRAR or 7-zip here. And then now you just have to double click here on the rustypsn.ex and the tool will open. Before you start downloading the patches, I want you to click here on this little gear so you can change the download location for the patches. In my case, I like to create a new folder on the emulator folder here called updates just so that I can keep things organized, you know? And now go back to rustypsn and then select pick folder, and then select that one updates folder that we just created. Remember, this is optional. This is up to you how you want to download this, but I like doing it like this. So now click here on save settings. Now we need the game's serial code to download its updates. So we're gonna go back to the emulator and you're gonna click on the game with the right button and you're gonna select the option from the bottom that says copy info, put your mouse on top and then select copy serial. Now go back to Rusty PSN and you're gonna paste the code right here on this bar, like this one. And then you're gonna click on search for updates. And just like that, Rusty PSN will list all the updates available for the game. There's only one for Skate 3, so go ahead and click here on download file. This one should be pretty quick. Now back on the emulator, you're gonna click on file once again, and this time click here on install packages. It should open the emulator folder by default, so double click on the updates folder, double click on the serial game code here, and inside the single update for Skate 3. Now double click on it, I'm going to ask if you want to install this, click on yes, wait a few seconds, and there you go. Now the game is updated. Next, we are going to tweak the emulator settings for Skate 3. So click on it with the right button, and then you're gonna click here on create custom configuration. Here on the CPU tab, there's this option here, preferred SPU threads. You're gonna change this one from auto to either 1, 2, or 3, but only if your CPU has less than 12 threads. This can fix the slow motion problem of this game on the emulator and also the choppy audio, which only happens if you have a CPU that has less than 12 threads. So if that's happening to you, this is the option you're gonna be changing here, either 1, 2, or 3. But like I said, this only happens if you have a CPU that has less than 12 threads. Everything else should be left on the default. Now head over here on the GPU tab. On renderer, make sure that Vulkan is selected here, but if your GPU is a little outdated, you're only gonna have OpenGL, which has worse performance than Vulkan, a lot of stutters in it. But if you do have Vulkan, go ahead and select it. On anti-aliasing, change it from auto to disable. This is required for improving the performance of the game. Here on anisotropic filter, you can change it from auto to 16x. This has minimal impact on performance and make the game looks much better. If you want to increase the game's resolution, keep the default resolution at the recommended 720p and increase it here on resolution scale. This game works fine when you increase the resolution. I tested it with 1080p and it works fine. So you can go all the way to 4K if your GPU can handle that, of course. On additional settings, check mark the right color buffers option here. This fixes a lot of glitches in the game. Now click on the advanced tab, and if you're planning to go beyond 60 FPS, you're gonna change here the V-Blink frequency to 60 to 120 Hz. This part is optional, but I like going here on the emulator tab and disable the show trophy pop-ups, the PPU compilation hint, and shader compilation. They can be annoying because every time the emulator is doing one of these, you're gonna get a notification on the corner of the screen. So I think that's a little annoying, so I turn them off. Also, if you experience an issue where objects are falling through the ground in-game, this can be fixed by heading here to the CPU tab and changing the SPU decoder to recompiler ASMJIT. But you should only change this if this issue is really happening, because this recompiler uses a bit more of your CPU. And with that, we're done here. So click on apply and then save custom configuration. Lastly, we just have to configure your controller. So click here on pads, and this emulator has an automatic mapping function. So if you already have your device plugged in, right here on handlers, you're gonna click on this bar here and you're gonna select the controller you're using. This emulator supports PlayStation controllers and Xbox as well. In my case, I'm using a Xbox controller, so I'm gonna select here X input, and just like that, the emulator would do the configuration for me. You can click on individual buttons if you want to change any of them, and it also supports keyboards as well, if that's what you wanna do here. So once you're done, go ahead and click here on save, and we're ready to start the game. So just double click on it. And when you start it for the first time, it's going to compile these PPU modules. This one is going to take a little while depending on how strong your CPU is, but in general, it shouldn't take long. Once it's done, the game will start as normal and you can start playing. I have many tutorial videos like this on the channel, so if you like what you saw, don't forget to subscribe, leave a like on this video, and also check out my other stuff. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you soon.